Hey guys, it's Saria. Welcome back to my channel. If this is the first video you're catching, I have been posting all week long on YouTube, Instagram, and TikTok just to celebrate Hocus Pocus week, which is what I've deemed this week. This is a collaboration that's been open to absolutely everyone. So even if you're not like a content creator, you are totally welcome to participate in any fashion that you see fit. So even if you're just watching the movie tonight and you want to snap a pic at the screen and put hashtag Hocus Pocus Week, I will eat it up, you guys. It hasn't started yet. I'm like pre-filming obviously, but I cannot tell you guys how excited I am to see all the Hocus Pocus content for an entire week. So today's video is actually going to be a ear tutorial. It's of the ears that I made for my bestie Erica. That video uploaded first. So day one was the ear unboxing and today is the ear tutorial. So if you guys want to see how I made those ears, then just keep watching. So first things first, I'm going to be using these wood disc ornaments. These are about 3.5 inches in diameter and I get them off of Amazon. I pick out the roundest ones that match to each other the best they can. And then I'll be using my foam and batting template, which is the smallest one linked down below for you guys, just to create that arch on the bottom that I'm going to cut out using a bandsaw. Now, if you don't have a bandsaw or a jigsaw, I'm honestly not 100% sure how to get this bottom part off, but I do think this method still might work if you left it perfectly rounded. As you can see here, I'm just comparing the two because I was a little bit worried that I placed it wrong, so I kind of give myself a couple options before cutting. So I actually did decide to paint these before I cut them just for the sake of time, but I'm going to start with a purple and a pink color. These are just acrylic paints from Walmart and I'm taking a sponge brush and just dabbing it on randomly. I do intend to ombre these colors together to create, you know, a really cool background for the image I plan on painting on them. So starting with the purple, I'm just dabbing it on randomly. Then I go straight into the pink with the exact same brush and start dabbing that one in as well. I am trying to blend my edges. I don't want anything to be super harsh. My goal with this coloring was to match the smoke that's coming out of the chimney of the house. So if you guys have seen Hocus Pocus, you know, there's the scene where like, they're like, look, they conjure, and the smoke coming out of the Sanderson sisters' home is a pinkish purple. So that is why I chose these colors. And then my edges still felt just a little bit harsh, so I went ahead and just started smoothing my brush over the top to blend everything together a little bit more. Next, I decided to add glitter. However, do not add glitter until you have painted your image. The glitter should be the absolute last step. I think I just got excited when I found it in my paint drawer. I got this from Walmart. It's so pretty, and it's basically glitter glue. The adhesive within it is clear, but the glitter is stunning. It is metallic and it's got so many colors and color flip to it. This is the more pinky one. And originally I thought, oh, it's not that big of a deal. I'll just paint around the outer rim in glitter like this and Winnie will just fit in the middle, but it did give me a few problems down the line. So again, I would not do this step until you are almost completely done. And I will point out when I think I should have done this later on in the video. But as you can see, this glitter is beautiful. Also, I want to point out on the backs of these, I'm going to do the exact same thing. So I'm going to do the pink, purple, and then the glitter. Now for Winifred originally, this was my reference photo, was the one of, you know, the character meet and greet of Minnie dressed as Winnie. But when I tried to sketch that out, it did not. This is like the thing of nightmares, you guys. Like, it's terrifying. So I decided to go with more of a cartoon Minnie Mouse style and just sketch her out as Winifred myself. I do feel like my paper drawing came out just a little bit better than the ear, but I'm also a very harsh critic of my own art, so I'm trying to be better at that. But I just sketched Minnie myself and then kind of turned her into Winifred. And now I'm going to re-sketch her onto the disc. Now, I sketched her onto the paper initially because I tried to do my transfer method that I've done in the past, but it did not work. So I did end up having to hand sketch her anyway, but at least I got to practice. I'm cutting through that because it was so hard to see. Right now I'm taking a little chisel that's for my silhouette machine and I'm chiseling off some of the glitter that's really chunky that
would be on top of Winifred. So I'm going ahead and taking that and just kind of taking off some of the really chunky glitter. This is the color that I used for the base of Winifred's hair. It's called Harvest Orange. Again, I get all my acrylic paints from Walmart, and I'm just going in and painting in her hair first. The orange is going to take a couple of coats, so just be patient with it. Paint a little bit, let it dry, and then go back in a few times. Orange is a really, really thin paint for some reason in any shade I buy. But I wanted to show you guys a close-up. This is the sketch. And then this is the color I used for her face. And I will be painting her face next, just going carefully. I am going to outline all of this in a paint marker in a minute, but still trying not to make a mess or like go crazy. Some of you might be like, Saria, why did you bother sketching the face before, you know, and then you're just gonna paint over it? And my answer to that is to make sure I could, just to get a little more practice in. So now I'm going back in and doing another layer of that orange paint, again, just trying to cover up the background that I had done, and then just cleaning up my edges a little bit. Next, I'm going in with this green color to do the base of Winifred's dress. We are going to be using two greens, but this is the darker green, so we're doing this one first. And I'm just going to paint her dress. Next, I am taking that same purple that we used for the background, and I'm just painting that center panel that's on her dress that is purple. We are also going to add the second layer of green and gold next, but I want to allow these layers to dry first. Next, I'm doing her face for a third time. I am a little sad because rewatching this back, I feel like the face that I painted over was my best rendition. And this one was a little bit trickier for me. It's just the eyes. I struggle with the eyes, but I still do think she came out super cute. So again, just resketching this with my pencil, and then I am going to go in with a paint marker and outline all of her features. Her eyes do get painted white, but everything else is just going to be with that paint marker, and then her lips will obviously be red. I did want to allow the paint marker to dry before going in and painting her lips, so I'm going to do another coat of orange on top of Winnie's hair. Using my skinniest, smallest brush, I am going to go ahead and dip it in some red paint and paint on Winnie's perfect little pout. I go back to using my paint marker and I'm just going to use this to outline the entire image. I am going to start with her face, but I will end up outlining the entire design. I think it helped make it pop on the background and also helped to clean up any lines that were a little bit smudgy. This is the other green that we're going to be using. It is really like a lime green, and I'm going to be using a sparse brush to just kind of stipple that on in different places to give her dress some texture. And then I'm going to be using a gold metallic acrylic paint to add the little details and accents. I did give her little belt that cinches her waist, and then for the designs I just did little dashes because this is such a tiny little piece of art that I could not do designs. My brushes are not that finite. And next I'm going back in with the marker and just outlining anything that I missed, cleaning up any edges. Something I do want to point out, because I think I missed it, is that I did paint her glove that shows white, because I wasn't sure if that was going to get cut off once I, you know, rounded out the bottom of the disc. So her hair was a little bit flat, and so I picked up a yellow-orange mixture acrylic paint, and then I'm just kind of adding some dimension to her hair. For the other side of the ears, the other disc, I repeated all of the steps for the background. I also repeated them on the back. So the back is just plain purpley pink with glitter. I'm going to show you guys that in just a second. But on this ear, I decided to write a quote instead of drawing Clarabelle and Daisy. I just honestly didn't think that if I took that on, that one, either wouldn't mess it up, or two, that her ears wouldn't get to her on time. So I decided to go for a quote instead. I just sketched it out in pencil and then outlined it using that same paint marker. And this is the back of the ear. I just want to show you guys, I just repeated the same steps. And then the quote right there, "Dost thou comprehend?" And next we're actually going to move on to the bow. So I'm using some green crushed velvet fabric. I went ahead and cut this rectangle into 8 inches by 5 inches, and we're just going to be using our hot glue gun to create hemlines. So I'm just doing a line of hot glue, folding over my edge and tapping it down into the hot glue, and I am going to do this all the way around the bow. Next we're going to fold our bow in on itself. So after I finish this hemline, you're going to see that I'm going to fold it like this and just tack down the edges with a dot of glue. Then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side and fold that over. I like the thickness that this gives to the bow. And then I will fold that edge over one more time to close it up. So now that we have our rectangle shape and all of the edges are closed, we're going to go ahead and accordion fold the bow and then pinch it in the center. I will be using a hot glue gun to just kind of tack down the center so that it doesn't move around while I'm using trim to wrap around the center. I did decide to use a gold trim just because that's what Winnie's costume looks like, so that made the most sense. Go ahead and put a dot of hot glue on the bottom of your bow and then tack down the ribbon, wrap it around, and glue the other end down and just snip off whatever excess you have of your trim. I didn't really have a place to set my phone to record myself slicing off the bottom of these, but they are cut now, and I'm going to just double check and make sure they're able to be attached and work on attaching them. So this next step is a little bit hard to film, and hopefully it works out, but you're gonna need a drill. I use a 1/4-inch pilot hole drill bit, and I am going to drill 3 holes into the bottom of both of these discs, just like that. Be really careful not to get too close to the edge of your disc, because I do at one point and it does chip off a little bit. So just be careful when you're working, and then obviously work on a steady table and be able to hang the ornament off the edge of it so that you don't nick your table or ruin a piece of furniture. I did want to show you guys the little mistake that I made. I was very frustrated by it, but I also realized that it was going to get covered up by the next steps. So right there, I had a little chip. So using black satin ribbon, I just get this from Dollar Tree. I'm going to use some masking tape to create an aglet. I learned that word. That's the end of the shoelace, the little plastic end of the shoelace. So I'm going to use the masking tape and create an aglet so that this feeds through the ear a little bit easier. You are going to loop it through all of the holes, but leave yourself some slack because the headband is going to slide through the slack that you create. So if you see here, I didn't pull it all the way tight. I've got little loopies open and ready so that I can stick the headband through like this. And then in a moment, we're going to hot glue this ear down and then use the ribbon as extra support to make sure that that ear is not going anywhere. So I do use my ear spacing template just to make sure that I'm getting a good spacing. And I mark it with a silver Sharpie on my black headband to make sure I can see it. And then I'm going to, this part is a teeny bit tricky. So I'm making sure that I have enough slack in my ribbon that it's not going to be in my way when I do this, because you have to leave it looped around the headband. That's just easier. Do a line of hot glue, firmly press the ear down into the hot glue and allow that to start to set before you pull the ribbon. So just glue this on like you would a normal set of ears. And then once the glue is dried all the way, then you're going to start to pull your ribbon tight and hot glue the ribbon down in place. So I put a dot of hot glue and then I pull my ribbon tight until it smushes down into the hot glue. And then I'm gonna wrap the end around and put it in the hot glue as well, and then cut off my excess. My ribbon did fray a little bit here. You can take a lighter and seal the edges of your ribbon if that's a problem for you. Just be very careful, obviously, because, you know, fire. And then I'm going to repeat these steps on the other side as well. So I'm just taking my time and making sure my ribbon is laying flat and pretty, and then just pulling that tight down into the hot glue that I've laid down. I'll cut off the excess and glue down the final flap. These are some of the sturdiest ears that I have ever made, you guys. Like, this ribbon trick, it really does the job. Like, this ear is going nowhere. So go ahead and repeat those steps for the other ear. And then we are going to attach the bow just by adding a dot of hot glue and firmly pressing it down into the center of the headband. This bow, the fabric was just a little bit floppy. It can definitely stand on its own, but I did go ahead and tack it down with just a dot of hot glue to each ear, because that way it sat a little bit more appealing to me. And that is the final step on these ears. Just a reminder, if you guys didn't see Erica unbox these, I will leave her video linked below if you guys want to see. And then also I will link all of my Hocus Pocus videos if you guys are looking for more Hocus Pocus content.
Thank you guys again for all of your love and support, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.